Hello students, this is Shweta Roy. This video is for Chapter 6, Geography, Part 1, Hydrosphere, Water. So in this video, we are going to discuss about distribution of water, different forms of water, hydrological cycle, that means water cycle, importance of the hydrological cycle, major oceans and their water circulations. So these are some of the important topics which we are going to discuss in this video. You already know that water is very significant resource of the earth. Water is very essential for the life. Without water, we cannot imagine life. Also, we know that ...71% of Earth's surface is covered with water. And because of this, our Earth is called watery planet or blue planet. Now the water which we have on the Earth is mainly found in rivers, lakes, glaciers, seas, oceans. And also we have underground water which we find below the surface of the water. Now all these water bodies together form the hydrosphere. This is together called hydrosphere. Now we have our topic, distribution of water. So as we have already discussed, our earth is covered 71% of our earth surface is covered with water, and because of this, earth appears blue from the outer space, and this is why it is called blue planet. Now we have a table here which shows the distribution of water on the earth surface. So we have 97.3% of water in oceans, 2.0% we have ice caps, 0.68% we have underground water, then we have 0.009% fresh water, lakes and inland seas, then we have 0.009% of water which we have salt lakes, 0.0019% we have in atmosphere, then 0.0001% we have in the rivers. So through this table we can understand that a large amount of water we have in oceans, and the ocean water is salty which human beings cannot use. So we have very less water as fresh water. In that also we have 2.77% of water, about 2.77% of water in ice caps and glaciers which we directly cannot use. So the water which is available for our use, the fresh water which is available for our use, is very very less, 0.003%, which we can find in rivers and water bodies. Now we will discuss about different forms of water. So we already discussed that we have water in water bodies as well as we have ice caps. And some of the water is present in the atmosphere also. So the water which we have in the form of ice caps, that is solid form of water. The water which we have in our water bodies like oceans and rivers in the form of water is liquid form of water. And the water which is available in the atmosphere is in the form of water vapor, and that is the gaseous form of the water. So we have three different forms or states of the water. We have solid, which is ice, we have liquid, which is water, and we have water vapor, which is steam, gas. So these are the three forms of water. Now these three forms of water are called three states of water. Also these three states of water are interconvertible. Interconvertible means they can change into all the three forms. Understood? Like ice can change into water, so solid can be changed into liquid. Now water can change again into ice, or water can change into water vapor also. The same way, if water is changing into water vapor, the water vapor can again change into water. That is interconvertible. Now these three states of water form a complete hydrological cycle, which we will discuss now. Okay, before discussing hydrological cycle, we will discuss about five oceans of the earth. We have five oceans on the earth, and these oceans are interconnected. They are connected with each other. Now the water level in all the oceans and seas is same everywhere. It remains same everywhere. And this uniform level is called mean sea level. Now if you are going to measure height of land and depth of water, that will be measured from mean sea level. We can take an example to understand it. Like Mount Everest is having 8,848 meters of height, which is above the sea level, matlab from the sea level. Okay, it is from the mean sea level. So Everest is having 8,848 meter height from the mean sea level. Now we have Mariana Trench. It is in the Pacific Ocean. It is having the greatest depth. Now from where to measure its depth? So you will measure this depth from the mean sea level. So if you will measure from mean sea level, the Mariana Trench is having 11,022 meter of depth from the mean sea level. So if you are going measuring any of the height or depth, that will be measured from mean sea level. Okay, now we'll go to the topic hydrological cycle. So my first question is, what would happen if hydrological cycle will not be there? That means why it is important to have a hydrological cycle? So if there is no hydrological cycle, that means if water is not able to change their states, water are not changing their states, what will happen? So the ice caps, the glaciers which we have will never melt, right? So there will be no water in the rivers. Then the water, if water will not change into water vapor, will not have the rainfall, right? So like this, there is a great importance of these interconvertible states of the water and hydrological cycle. Now, what is hydrological cycle? So, hydrological cycle refers to the circulation of water within the Earth's hydrosphere in different forms. That is, the liquid, solid, and the gaseous forms. Now, this is a continuous process. So, continuously water is changing its form and circulates between ocean, atmosphere, and land. Now, the cycle describes the movement of water on, in, and above this earth surface. Now, water changes its states all the time because of the process of evaporation and condensation. You must have read about evaporation and condensation. So, what is evaporation? In evaporation, water converts into water vapor because of the heat of the sun. So, evaporation is a process in which water converts into water vapor due to the heat of the sun. Now, this sun's energy regulates the whole process of the water cycle. Because of this evaporation process, the water which is there in the ocean and land, that changes into water vapor and it enters into atmosphere. When it cools down, the water vapor changes into tiny water droplets and they form clouds. And this process is called condensation. So, condensation is a process in which water vapor changes into tiny droplets of water. Okay. Now, the rainwater runs into sea from where it gets evaporated, and like this the complete rainwater runs into the sea from where it gets evaporated, and the hydrological cycle completes like this. Now, this hydrological cycle is an endless process. It has no beginning, no end. It is a continuous process. Now, here we have an information for you. World Water Day. World Water Day is celebrated annually on 22nd of March. It was established by United Nations in 1992. Now, the aim of this to pay attention on the world's water crisis as well as the solutions to address it. Now we have the topic importance of the hydrological cycle. Why this cycle is important? So it regains the water lost from the water bodies. Whatever water goes through the evaporation process, it again comes through the rain precipitation. It ensures the distribution of water to all areas of the earth's surface. It recharges the underground water. Also, it maintains continuous supply of fresh water to the rivers. As you know, the rain water is the purest form of water. Now we have some questions to check your progress. Water is a precious resource of the earth's surface. This also includes water in oceans and freezing in glaciers. Now answer the questions given below. How is water a resource? Name the three states of water. Perform an activity to know more about the cyclic nature of water. So in this you need to do the questions as your homework. Now we will discuss about major oceans and their water circulation. Now we have already discussed that oceans are the huge reservoirs of the earth's water, and there are five oceans on the earth. We have Pacific Ocean, Atlantic Ocean, Indian Ocean, Arctic Ocean, Southern Ocean. So first we will discuss about Pacific Ocean. It is the largest ocean on the earth. It covers 1/3 of the earth's surface. Now the deepest point which is there in the Pacific Ocean is Mariana Trench. And it is having greatest depth, and that is 11,022 meter. The shape of this ocean is roughly triangular in shape. Then we have Atlantic Ocean. It is the second largest ocean in the world, and it is having S shape. It provides the busiest ocean route for trade and transport. Then we have Indian Ocean, and the ocean has its name after our country India. It facilitates trade and travel between eastern and western hemisphere. Then you have Arctic Ocean, which surrounds the North Pole, and most of the part of this ocean remains frozen for most part of the year. Now then you have Arctic Ocean or Southern Ocean, and this ocean joins the Pacific, Atlantic and Indian Ocean. It remains frozen for most of the part of the year. It is not a vast body of water, but a vast ice sheet. It surrounds the South Pole. So these are our oceans. I hope you all understood all the topics taught in this video. Thank you.